The APEC Business Advisory Council of PNG this week hosted an event to acknowledge its gold sponsors. According to APEC PNG member Wayne Golding, this support from corporate sponsors was crucial to the country's successful hosting of the APEC CEO Summit and related APEC events.
Without your sponsorship, this will never have happened. There's no doubt about it. And we were so lucky that you were able to come forward with your sponsorship so early, because that provided us confidence to move forward. And it is a difficult task for a small economy to host the biggest economic summit in the world. And people say it can't be. I said it is, because it's 21 countries represent 60% of the global business.
APEC Minister Tkatchenko also acknowledged the support from corporate houses, reaffirming the government's view that the support from business was a crucial investment for the country's economy.
So much for your loyal and continuous support for the CEO Summit and for APEC. It's a very important sponsorship that it means a lot to ensure that this event is a successful event. The investment and opportunities now and into the future are the ones that are going to benefit you and your companies in the long term. That's what we want. And for your sponsorship to come forward and support what the team is doing, that's greatly appreciated.
So far, the leaders of Japan, Russia, China and America have confirmed their attendance for the closing session of the CEO Summit. And keeping with the theme of digital innovation, PNG is aiming to have sessions live-streamed via satellite, something which hasn't been done before for APEC meetings.
And I want to demonstrate to the world that PNG is a bit slow, a little bit backward on technology, but the most important thing, we can do it if we try hard enough to do it.
At this stage, planning is going well, with APEC PNG confident that the discussions from the CEO Summit will go a long way to influence policies for APEC member countries.
And that's what the APEC area is all about, is to push the minister and his colleagues to make better policies, to invest in better infrastructure so our economy can blossom and all the private sector in this room can at least breathe a bit easier.
Mary Batulo, National MTV News.